ברשות מוריי ורבותיי, ובדפי משנה של השם, we are now preparing ourselves to receive the Torah. And as you know, there is two kinds of receiving the Torah. There is receiving the Torah and in Shavuot, and there is receiving the Torah every day, every Shabbos, every holiday. It's like a wedding. There is a kind of a wedding that the day of the wedding is the wedding, and after it's a man or woman, they are married, or they live so much, they live so peacefully, the couple, it's like every day they are married. It's like in their marriage, it's like every day. You know the difference between a wedding, a marriage every day, and while marriage once in a life, it's when a man gets married once in a life, that's it, he's married. But when, and as we know, that when a man gets married once in a life, and his life, of course, is excited, you know, everything he makes sure that everything is ready. He makes sure that that the wedding, the marriage is well prepared. You know, everything was perfect. And after the wedding, after the marriage, they go home, and after 1 week, 2 weeks, now they are man or woman. That's it. They only maybe once in a year they will do an anniversary of their wedding. You know, it's an anniversary, maybe if they are lucky, after 25 years, they will do a big party of that they supported each other 25 years. And that's it. But the real wedding is to feel the marriage every day. To feel that every day it's like I got married. A lot of people, they behave so well, they respect so well their husband, and the wife, and the husband respects so well his wife. It's like today they got married. And I think this is what Hashem wants from us when it comes to between us and the Torah and Hashem. That every day, the Shavuot, the Matan Torah, it's not just once a year, or once that happened a few thousand years ago. No, the Matan Torah, the Matan Torah, it's a wedding between a man, the man with the Torah. It should be every day, every single day, we should feel this wedding between us and the Torah. What is a wedding? What is a marriage? A marriage is a responsibility that the man, he feels that he's responsible about his wife. And the wife as well, she's responsible about her husband, about her duty, what she should do in the house, what she should do for her husband, and what the husband should do with his wife. This is a responsibility. This is a responsibility. And this responsibility, it should be renewed every single day, between the man and the woman. So always you can live peacefully with shalom. So the Torah Kedusha, we should do exactly the same. We should feel about the Torah that, like it's every day we receive the Torah. Every day we are here with, it's like today was Shavuot. Now we understand. I would like to to remind you that on Shavuot, of course, on Shavuot, it's like we renew our matana, we renew the matana that Hashem give us. As you know, that this matana, this gift that it's, we call this gift Torah, this gift that we call it Torah, it's a gift that we should take very care of this Torah. It's a, why the real pleasure that a man can have, Behemet, I'm telling you this by experience, the best pleasure that a man can have only when he studies Torah, when he understands Torah, and he has a contact with the Torah. It's like he's married with the Torah. It's like, you know, it's like, as you know, there is a big responsibility between a man and a woman that their marriage will be a success. So that our marriage with the Torah will be a success, we need a big respect. We should respect well the Torah Kedusha. So tonight, it's Shavuot. What about next week? Well, next week is Shavuot. Next week as well is Shavuot. And what about the week after? It's Shavuot. Now, we understand that Arizal HaKadosh, he said that the night of Shavuot, there is a special tikkun. There is a special tikkun, a special limud that we should learn. But not everybody understands this special tikkun. Not every, unfortunately today, not everyone knows that. But not everyone. So that's why this there is a place, the world, that they do the tikkun, like in Morocco, we should do the tikkun of Shavuot. But there is other places that they don't know what it is the tikkun. So they study Torah. Even the Torah is a tikkun. I mean, can you imagine? The most important is to sit and learn Torah. This is the most important. To sit, it's a big souvenir. You know, once in a life, as it said in the Zohar Kadosh, that the tikkun of Lil Shavuot, of the night of Shavuot, it's better, it's more important than the tikkun of Hoshana Rabbah. Can you imagine Hoshana Rabbah? It's before Simchat Torah. We don't sleep all night, and it's like Yom Kippur. And we pray, we do shofar, we cry. You know, it's like a Yom Kippur on Hoshana Rabbah. And Shavuot, it's more important than Hoshana Rabbah. Why? Because the Zohar HaKadosh said, anyone who studied Torah at the eve of Shavuot and he does the tikkun, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he come and he listen to him and he bless him and he bless his children. He bless his children. Can you imagine that? And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he write the name of the man who studied that night. And he write it for memory. That means that HaKadosh Baruch Hu he will remember that man. My question is, what's special tonight? Why it's so good? Anyone who studied Torah tonight, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will write him in the book of Zichronot, of book of memories. And every day, every time, everywhere HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he look at this name, and he will remember him, and will take care of him. Why? The reason is, because usually it's tomorrow Shavuot. It's tomorrow Shavuot. And usually we should go to sleep, have energy, go to bed, go to sleep, so tomorrow we can wake up and receive the Torah. This is the logical way. But instead of doing that, what do? We don't sleep all night. We do tikkun. We are excited. We want to be ready. We want to study Torah all night. We receive the Torah with this big preparation. Can you imagine? I would like just to tell you this. Before a wedding, there is always a threat. Maybe the chatan will not attend, you know, he will be under the chuppah. Maybe the kalash will not she will not come to the chuppah. Just imagine if there is tension between the chatan and the kala, the day of their wedding. Maybe one of them will not come. There is a tension, a big tension. And can you imagine? The chatan is there, and the chatan is worried. Maybe the kala she will not come. And here is the kala. Not only the kala she came, but the kala she was there one night before the wedding. Can you imagine how much the chatan will be happy? Yes or no? Huh? Yes?
Yes.
Can you imagine how much the chatan will be happy? Can you imagine that? So there is a big etzara. The etzara knows that we'll be preparing ourselves from Pesach till Shavuot. We'll be counting days. Today is the first day, the last day of the Omer. We'll be counting 49 days to receive the Torah. Here's the day is coming. So the Sarah is worried that by receiving the Torah, by receiving this matana, this gift that Hashem is going to give us, we will be inspired by the Torah all the year. And all the year, every day, we will make sure that we receive the Torah every day. So the Satan, the Sarah is worried. So the Satan, he will do all what he can to avoid us to receive the Torah with simcha. There is a big risk that we will receive the Torah toward the Torah, but with not simcha. But what do we do? Not only we receive the Torah with simcha, but we study Torah. We go toward the Chatan, which is the Kadosh Baruch Hu. We don't sleep all night. We big Hashem. We study Torah. Yes, we want to marry you. Yes, we want to study Torah. Can you imagine how much HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he is happy. HaKashem was excited. HaKashem was worried. Maybe the Satan, maybe the Tzara, he will not let us receive the Torah with joy, with simcha. But not only, but HaKashem, he see the contrary. HaKashem, he see how much we love him. No, we don't wait till tomorrow to receive the Torah. But we start to prepare ourselves all night to receive the Torah. So when Hashem sees that, he come and he bless. This is the way I explain the Zohar HaKadosh. This is that why the most important is, no matter if you do the Tikkun or you study Torah, the most important is to sit and learn Torah. If you can do the Tikkun, study the Tikkun. Otherwise, study Torah because the Tikkun it's to repair what our parents did not do because they want to sleep the night before Matan Torah. This is the Tikkun. But there is another community. They said we don't need to repair them. The most important is to study Torah. The most important is that our parents, they received the Torah, even that they did not do the Tikkun, they received the Torah, so we learn, we study the Torah. Now, we understand something incredible. What that means? There is a pasuk that when Mashiach will come, Be'ezat Hashem, there will be no death anymore. The death will be finished forever. What the connection? This pasuk with Shavuot. What it is the connection? This pasuk with Shavuot. I would like just to tell you this. Let's count the first letter of Ubala Hamavet Anesa. Ubala is there is a vav, there is a he, and there is a lamed. How much is it altogether? Ubala Hamavet Lanesa. There is vav, there is he. And there is Lamed. Begematria, Rashi Tevot Begematria, 41. Yes? And with the Kolel is 42. What the meaning of 42 is Vishinatam Lebanecha Vidibata Bam. Bam it's Tere. Bam it's 42. That means HaKadosh Baruch Hu wants us to study Torah in any situation we are. If we are ill, we should study Torah. If we are not well, we should study Torah. If we are traveling, we should study Torah. All business, we should study Torah. I mean, all our lives should be with Torah. I mean, even by working, you don't speak Lashon Hara. By working, you make sure that you don't look at bad things. It's studying Torah. What is Torah? That means that you have to go the way of Hashem. This is studying Torah. Studying Torah is not only to open a book and to study Torah with an open book open. No, to do, even if you are quiet, if you don't speak Lashon Hara, it's Torah. You do business with Emunah, with no stealing from nobody, it's Torah. You don't swear. You don't swear. You pray. It's Torah. Everything is Torah. You know, when Mashiach will come, be'ezrat Hashem, there will be no death anymore. People, ubala amavet ha-netzah. You know what is this netzah? Netzah is forever. We call the Torah nitzchit. The Torah is forever. Netzah. It's forever. Today, you are here, this word, you study Torah. You go up there, after 120 years, there is Torah. When Mashiach will come, there is Torah. Bashamayim, there is Torah. This is the Torah, its name Netzach. Emet, it's something that is true. You cannot deny the existence of the Torah. When Hashem gives the Torah to the Bnei Israel, the Gemara said, Ne'akar ha-mavet. The Satan, he was finished. The Hashem, he decided to kill the Malach HaMavid, the angel of death. There will be no Satan anymore. But only, the only problem was the Jews, they had to wait till Moshe Rabbeinu will come with the Torah. But unfortunately, they did not wait for Moshe to come, and they did the Egel, and because they did the Egel, so the Malach HaMavid, the angel of death, he came back again, and there is death. But the death was supposed to stop at Matan Torah. The Gemara said that the Yetzara ne'akam miliba, the Yetzara was finished on Shavuot. On Matan Torah, the Yetzara was finished, that's it. But unfortunately, the Bnei Yisrael did the idolatry, they did the Egel. And because they did the idolatry, they did the Egel, so the Satan came back. Be'ezrat Hashem, now we prepare ourselves, now we repair this with the Torah, till Mashiach will come. When Mashiach will come, Ubala amavet ha-netzah. Death will be finished. You know when somebody died? When we buried him, we repeat that pasuk. Ubala amavet ha-netzah. When we do Yiskor, we will have a hashkaba for a dead person. We do that pasuk. Why? Because even the dead person, they are sad while they die. No one wants to die, so we give them a consolation. Don't worry, there will be a time that will come, and there will be a resurrection, and you will live again. You know, the Gemara said when somebody die, he screamed so loud. But thanks God, we don't hear his screaming. Because a person, no one wants to die, no one. So, okay, those people who commit suicide, don't bring proof from them. Because when they committed suicide, they did not know what they were doing. They lost their mind. But usually people don't want to die. People want to live. People want to live. People, they are willing to pay any price just to live. Just to live. People don't want to live. People don't want to die. They don't want to die. And when the soul, before she leaves the body, the body cries. She begs the soul, please, don't let me. Please, I don't want to die. It's very sad, the body. And they scream. You cannot imagine how sad is the body when he leaves the house. How sad is the body when we buried him. So we give him a consolation. It will come a day that will be no death anymore. That will there will be resurrection. So now we know what is the meaning of this pasuk Ubala Amavet Hanetzach, that the death will be finished forever. What the connection between this pasuk and Shavuot? Because on Shavuot we receive the Torah, and with the Torah the death was supposed to stop. And unfortunately, it did not stop because the Jews did the Egel. Now, but Baruch Hashem, there is a consolation. When Mashiach will come, it will be finished again. This is the Torah. This is the Torah Kedusha. So, Be'ezat Hashem, if we want to have, you know, the Zichut, to have Gan Eden, to have Olam Haba, after 120 years, and to see Mashiach coming, Be'ezat Hashem, we need to study Torah. We need to study Torah. I would like just to tell you this. You cannot imagine. Now I understand. I would like just to, all of you, I would like just to listen to this. When Moshe was in the Shamayim, he had an argument with the Malachim, with the angels. The angels, they didn't want that Moshe, he will receive the Torah. At the end, Moshe, he won the argument with them. He told them, you don't need the Torah, because you, the Malachim, you, the angels here, you don't have Yitzhara. There is no killing, there is no stealing. The angels there, they are okay. There, in this world, there is people who kill, people who steal. There is Lashon Hara, but there is nothing. Kabet, respect your father and mother. Only in this world, there, the Malachim, the angels, they have no father and mother, so they don't need the Torah. There is no Shabbos there is no Taref there is no Tefillin there, only here. So Moshe Rabbeinu, he persuaded the angels that they don't need the Torah. And at the end, the Gemara said that all the angels, they give to Moshe Rabbeinu presents. They give him gifts. Each Malach, he give him a gift. What kind of gift? There is no Cartier, or there is no watches, there is no cars, there is no material gift. The gift that they give him is Razeh Torah, the secret of the Torah. Each Malach, he has a secret that he learned or he heard from Hashem. That he gave it that to Moshe Rabbeinu. So Moshe Rabbeinu, Anital Amarom Shavit Hashivim, Moshe Rabbeinu Alav Shalom, he learned a lot of Torah from the Malachim. Even the angels of death, he gave to Moshe Rabbeinu a secret. How to stop death. Now my question is, how the Malach HaMavet, he gave his the secret of death to Moshe Rabbeinu. The Malach HaMavet, his duty is to kill people. Yes or no?
Yes.
So how Malach HaMavet, he give the secret how to stop him not to kill people? You understand the question?
Yes.
It's like if you know the numbers of the lottery, would you give the numbers to somebody else?
No.
Of course no. If you know the numbers of the lottery, and by filling the coupon, the paper, you'll be a millionaire, you will win. Would you give this to people? No, of course. So how the Malach HaMavet, his job is to kill people. He's the angel of death. By giving his secret to Moshe Rabbeinu, it's finished. He will have no job anymore. So how he did? Now I understand. Now my answer is, the Malach HaMavet, why he give when he saw that the Jews they gonna receive the Torah, he understood that now if the Jews will receive the Torah, he's finished. So he don't need anymore this secret. You understand? He knows that now he doesn't need this secret anymore. Because the Torah is nisit, because the Torah is, we call the Torah Chayim, the life. If the Jews were Etz Hayim Elohim Hazikim Ba, is the tree of life. By receiving the Torah, by receiving the tree of life, he don't need this secret. So he said to himself, why I need this secret? Why do I need it? So I may teach it to Moshe. I don't need it anymore. That way he gave him the secret. But he was very clever, the Satan. After giving the secret to Moshe Rabbeinu, and the Jews received the Torah 3 days after, the Satan, he didn't want to give up. He said, I will not give up. I still have a chance. Until Moshe Rabbeinu, he's up there, maybe I can push the Jews to do idolatry. And by pushing them to do idolatry, so all the Torah they receive, it's not anymore, anyway, it's finished. The death will not stop. The death will not be banished. And that's what he did. The Yitzhara, he showed the Jews, he pushed the Jews to do the Avodah Zarah, to do the idolatry, and he did it. My friend, how much we should be attached to Hashem, and to appreciate that even that we did the idolatry, Hashem still gave us the matana. He still gave us this beautiful presence that it's called Torah. But Be'ez Hashem will Mashiach will come. Ubala mavet ha-netzah. This Ubala mavet ha-netzah, this pasuk, it should take place on Shavuot when the Jews receive the Torah. As I said now, the proof is that death should stop at Shavuot. The proof is that the Malach HaMavet, even his secret, he gave it to Moshe Rabbeinu. How to stop death? How to stop death? But unfortunately, the Jews, they did not wait for Moshe to come out, down after when he went there to stay there 40 days. Because they did not wait for him, and they did the idolatry, so they lost their battle. The Satan, the Malach HaMavet, came back again. But Be'ezrat Hashem, when Mashiach will come, we will reduce his force, and we'll finish with him. Now we know that Be'ezrat Hashem, when Shavuot came, and we studied the Megillat Rut, what we should think when we read the Megillat Rut. Who was Rut? Rut was a convert girl. She was a convert girl. She was a Goya. She was the daughter of the king of Moab. And she converted herself. And she converted herself when she was in a very bad situation. She needed a lot of courage, a lot of strength. She was the daughter of a king. Her husband died. Her mother-in-law, she's a poor woman. And now her mother-in-law, she wants to go back to Israel. And the Ruth, she said, I'm going to go with you. I want to live poor. I want to be Jew. I want to receive the Torah. I love Hashem. Your God is my God. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine? Usually, a person who don't need nothing, and he live very well. Why should he leave his kind, his way of living, to go somewhere else to live poorly? Why? Why? And the root, she was convinced that Hashem is the God. She said to Naomi, Eloheich Elohai, your God is my God. The same, that means, the same way that you feel how much you love your God, I love your God. And your God is my God, is my Hashem. And I love him so much. And I make up my mind. I don't want to live in my palace. I don't want to live in this country. I want to go to live poorly in your country. This is Matan Torah. We need, on Matan Torah, we need Chizuk. We need a laptop encouragement. So we get encouragement from Ruth. We get encouragement from Yitro. That's why the parashat of Matan Torah is written, the parashat of Yitro. That's why we read parashat Ruth, the Megillat Ruth, on Shavuot. Because on Shavuot, when we talk about the Matan Torah, we think to ourselves, look at this woman. She was a Goya. She was the daughter of a king. And she did a lot of it amtsut. She put a lot of kohot on herself. Because Naomi, she did all what she can to persuade her not to come with her. And she didn't want. She's now going to go with you. I want to study Torah. Your God is my God. I don't want to stay here. If you go, it's like you kill me. How can I live without you? How can I live without the Torah? I can't. It's incredible. Incredible, incredible, incredible. That's why we read this on Shavuot, to give to ourselves, because Divrei Torah tzrichim chizuk. We need a lot of encouragement. We need a lot of encouragement, because when it comes to Torah, there is a lot of itzara. I want to persuade you. Hey, what are you going to do with the Torah? What do you need the Torah for? So we give you a proof. Look at Ruth. She left everything behind her to go to live under the Derech Hashem. Look about it, what he did. He left everything behind him. He left his throne. He was the king of everybody. And he went poorly to the desert to receive the Torah. You know Parashat Bamidbar? It's a beautiful parasha. And Parashat Bamidbar, it said there, וידבר השם אל משה במדבר סיני, והשם ספוק to משה in the desert of Sinai. בשנה השנית, the second year after the exit from the Jews from Egypt, and after one year they did the Mishkan, beautiful Mishkan. What the meaning of Mishkan? And then they did the inauguration of the Mishkan, and Hashem count them. What the meaning of the Mishkan? The meaning of Mishkan, you know what it is, Mishkan? Mishkan, it's the tabernacle where Hashem resides. And the desert, Hashem gives the Torah to the Jews. Hashem wants to teach us, usually people, according to the environment where they live, they become. If you live in a rich area, that means that you are rich. A rich man will not live in a poor area. A poor man, he will not live in a rich area because he can afford it. Usually in the desert, It's a desert. There is no education. There is no university. There is nothing. Usually people live in desert. They are people of the desert with no education, with nothing. Look about those Jews. Look at the Jews. 1 year they were slaves in Egypt with no education in Egypt, with nothing. And they came to the desert. And the desert, it's worse than the country, because desert, there is nothing. You see only sands. That's what there is. But even that the Jews were in the desert, they built up the Mishkan. They changed from slaves to free people. Only through the Torah, it makes you a change. The Torah changes you. The hashpa'ah, the influence from the Anani Kavod. Ay. Even that they were in the desert. Desert, that there is nothing. There is no culture. No, nothing in the desert. Desert, midbar, shomem, nothing there. They become dordea. They become a big generation. With Torah, wherever you are, you can be in the desert, you can be a big man, a big tzaddik, a gaon you can be. With no Torah, you can be in Paris, you can be in New York. With no Torah, you can be anywhere you want. You will be like an animal. And this is Rabotai, this is the reason why the Hashem, he let the Jews in the desert a while, just to teach them how to become a nation. And the Jews, they become a nation only in the desert. Can you imagine that? Look, Ruth, she was at the palace. Look at Ophrah, her sister. Both of them, they were born in the palace. They have the same education. They got married to two Jewish people. But look what happened to them. One, Ophrah, she stayed, she remained in Moab, and she got married to an old Jewish man after her husband, the Jewish one, he died. And her sister Ruth, she went to Israel, to Eretz Israel with her mother-in-law. The same education, sisters, maybe they were twins, maybe they were not twins, I don't know, but they had parents, and they had one mother-in-law, Naomi. What was the difference between them? Two sisters. One, she remained in Moab, and she had children, Rishaim, like Goliath. And the other one, she had children, and one of the grandchild was David, who killed Goliath. What is the difference between those two sisters? What I learned from here is, you can't be Jew, and if you don't study Torah, and if you don't do from the Torah your life, you can lose everything. When Ruth, she said, Eloheich Elohai, your God is my God, your people are my people, your country is my country, that means that the way she was all the time, she was living for Hashem, and now she declared what was in her heart. But Ophrah, her sister, okay, she was married to a Jewish man. But when it came to leave the country and to go to live in Israel, like a poor woman, she couldn't accept it. That means that her life was more material than spiritual. This is Shavuot, my friend. That's what we learn from Ruth. You can be a rich man, but don't forget, when you come to the Torah, is the Torah that riches. That's what you take with you. That's what we learn from Ruth. A lot of to learn from Ruth. Ruth, she was not Jewish. She became Jew. We are Jewish. Our grandfather was Jewish. Our parents were Jewish. So for us, it should be easy. For it was very difficult to become Jew, and she became. That's why we learned this on Pesach. I would like to finish with this, the Shemitah. You know, the Shemitah, the Parashah of Shemitah, it was said in Parashat Behar Sinai. Parashat Behar. And it's incredible. What the connection between this Parashah of Shemitah, that this Parashah was saying that she was said to Moshe in Har Sinai. All the Torah was said to Moshe in Har Sinai, not only the Parashah of Shemitah. So why the Torah said, "Vayedaber Hashem el Moshe behar Sinai lemor," Hashem spoke to Moshe in Har Sinai, and he spoke to him about the Shemitah. What the connection? Why? You know, there is a lot of answers, but I thought a beautiful answer. When Moshe went to the Shamayim, behar Sinai, from Har Sinai, and Har Sinai was a lot of fire in Har Sinai. And the people, they saw Moshe Rabbeinu was walking in the fire. And then from there he went to the Shamayim to receive the Torah. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu protect Moshe Rabbeinu from the Malachim. The Malachim, they wanted to hurt Moshe Rabbeinu. And HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he protected Moshe Rabbeinu. So Hashem, I want to tell you, the same way that I protected Moshe from the hand of the angels and the Shamayim, me Hashem who protect Moshe not to get burned from the fire, I protect anyone who take care of the Shemitah, anyone who work, who give up the 7 years, he don't work the 7 year of the Shemitah, and he has Emunah B'tachon Hashem, I will give him the Parnasa. As we know that if there is a mitzvah in the Torah that if you have a land, you can work your land during 6 years, and the 7 year you should let your land free, like Shabbat. Like on Shabbat, you're not allowed to work. So that what you should do to all your gardens, all your trees. The 7 years, it's free for everybody. Give up, don't work, don't do business with that. It's terrible. Can you imagine a man who has thousands of trees? How many millions he can lose? It's terrible. And Hashem, he said, you should have Emunah. Even that you lose the 7 years, I will give you back 3, 10, 20 times more. You losers, I will pay you. You must be big Baal Emunah. Because it's not easy. That's why this parasha was given Har Sinai. That means the one who, Hashem, he said, me Hashem, who took care of Moshe in Har Sinai, and the Shamayim, that I protected him, I will protect anyone who will keep Shemitah. That's why this parasha of Shemitah was given in Har Sinai. It mentioned that it was given in Har Sinai. My friend, when you do business, if you don't have the business in your hand, it's not a business. My friend, I'm sorry to tell you this. Today there is a lot of business who is done between banks, on papers. You never saw the money that you won. When you lose, you don't even know what you lost. Because you did not see the business in your hand. Usually a business, when you do a business, you should look at the business. Have it in your hand. Have your stock in your hand. Have the diamond in your hand. Have the gold in your hand. You cannot have all this on papers. There is no security. It's a good business, but it could be a bad business as well. The Kinyani Torah, the business of the Torah, you ohez b'Torah. You must have the Torah in your hand. This is the business of the Torah. It's not. I know that's why the Torah said, "Be careful! Don't forget the Torah. If you forget the Torah, it's dangerous. Because do you forget how much money you have? No. So how you forget you don't forget the money. You forget the Torah. No. Be careful. You must have ahizah b'Torah. You have to hold it in your hand." משה רבינו עליו השלום. משה קיבל תורה מסיני, he received the Torah from Hashem. He received it, קיבל, קבלה, קיבל. משה קיבל ומסרה, and he gave it. I mean, we cannot say Moshe received and he did not give. No, Moshe received and he gave. He learned with the Klal Israel. He gave them what he received. Moshe kibel, he received and he gave. The problem is, he gave, but did anyone receive what he gave? He want to give. Is there is any hand who want to receive? Moshe kibel, Moshe received from Hashem. Umsara, Moshe want to give it. If there is anyone who wants to receive from me, Moshe is proclaiming. If there is anyone who wants to receive, those who will receive, they will win. Now we understand. I would like to finish this. The parashat Behar Bechukotai, and after Bamidbar, all those parashayot. We learn about Torah, about Har Sinai, how much we should learn Torah be'amal, with effort. The Torah was given in Har Sinai, Behar Sinai, Bechukotai, Bamidbar, the desert. We should repeat this every time. Every time, every year, every second, we receive the Torah. Every time, every year, every second, we receive the Torah from the hand of Hashem, if only we want. If only we want. If we only want. Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, the first time when he saw him in the mountain of Sinai, he told him, Moshe, when the Jews will leave Egypt, I'll meet you here. And here, in Har Sinai, I'll give you the Torah. I give you the Torah. Behar Bechukotai. Bechukotai is laws. There is no reason why we should learn Torah. It's a law. You should learn Torah. Why? It's a law. But it's a law that we don't know the reason. But I know the reason. The Torah is Chok. It's Chok. Chok, it's a law. It's like Chok Paraduma. It's a law. We don't know why. Why we should not touch a woman, Nida. It's a law. We don't know why. We know why we should not kill. We know why we should not steal. But why we should not touch a woman that she's Nida? We don't know. Why we should not wear Sha'atnes? It's a law. We don't know why. We don't know why. But it's Chok. And Torah, it's Chok. To study Torah, it's Chok. Can you imagine the Shemitah? It's a Chok. To work 6 years, at the 7 year you should not work. All the business that the lands give it to poor people. It's not yours. Don't do business with that. Why? It's a law. It's Torah. Behar Bechukotai, and the Har Sinai, this mitzvah of Shemitah was given. What it is the reason? Bechukotai. It's a law. Don't ask questions. And do it with effort. And there is a lot of effort in the Shemitah. To respect Shemitah, it's too much. Wow. How much effort I have to put to close my eyes when I see people entering my lands and they take food, they take all the trees. Oy. In one minute, I'm hungry. I'm angry. I want to tell them, all of them, hey, get out from my lands. Get out. I don't want to see you here. And I have to resist. No. I should have a bitachon. It's a law. This is why I should do that to me. Why you give me this kind of mitzvah? I have to give up of my all my business this year. Well, this it's a chok. Myself, emuna nakosh baruch hu. I need a lot of emuna on Hashem to do that. I need I have to study a lot of Torah with a lot of effort to accept why I have to do all this, all this kind of mitzvot. My friend. When the angel of death, Be'ezat Hashem, when Mashiach will come, the angel of death, Ubila Amavet Anetzah, he will finish. He will have no no strength anymore. The true, the Torah that it's emet, the Torah it's eternal, it's forever. The Torah that was given to Hashem, to by Hashem to Am Israel, ubala amavet hanetzah. The Torah was swollen, the death. There will be no death anymore. Because anyone who studies Torah will be, the Torah is Chaim. Anyone who studies Torah will be Chai, will be alive. This is Shavuot. Shavuot Shlim, the Shlimut. The Shavuot is the Shlimut, perfection. Or Shavuot, we become Pakfe, Shalem, to receive the Torah. A man with Shalem, he don't need to die. Now, we know that why Yaakov Abinu, Igia Lishlimut, Yaakov Abinu is the only one that when he arrived, the Torah said, Igia Shalem. He was perfect. And that's because he was perfect, the Torah didn't mention about him death. That's why the Torah said, Yaakov Lomet. He did not die. The Torah didn't say about it that he died. Why? Because he was perfect. He achieved the perfection. And anyone who is perfect, he can die. Be'ezat Hashem, when Hashem he gave to the Bnei Israel to count 7 years, seven weeks, Shlemot, seven weeks, and all weeks, 49 days. And after 49 days, Hashem said, now I give you the Torah. Now we are Shalem. They repair all the Mem Tet Sha'arit Tumah, they repair all the 49 degrees of Torah, of Tumah that they were in. They repair, they become big tzaddikim. So the death would stop. The death was supposed to be stopped. And the Malach HaMavit was supposed to be finished when Moshe Rabbeinu will arrive after 40 days. Unfortunately, they did the Egel. And Be'ezat Hashem, because he did the Egel, the Malach HaMavit took back again his positions to carry on killing people. Be'ezat Hashem, when Mashiach will come, everything will be finished. And Be'ezat Hashem, I pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that Hashem give you, to all of you, Barakha V'Atzlacha B'Gi'ut, Parnasa Tova Ken Ratzon. And Be'ezat Hashem, we should live till we will see this pasuk coming. Ubala amavet lanetzah. There will be big shavuot. Be'ezat Hashem, the Gemara said, when Mashiach will come, Kadosh Baruch Hu will give a big shiur, and after the shiur, it will be the end of the Malach HaMavit. Ubala amavet lanetzah. It will be the new shavuot when Mashiach will come. It will be a new world. And Yeratzon that Hashem will help us to be mitaken all what we should be mitaken in earth. Amen. Yeratzon.